My name is Jonas Lau Magnussen, and in this video I'll show you how to draw a Viking Age raven in the Ringrike style. Let's start by making two circles, one above the other. Make sure the space in between is the same size as the circles themselves. The top one is the joint for the wings, and the lower one is the hip joint. I'll just connect them here, and then we'll make a line for the body shape going up here to the head. And this to the right is the curve of the tail. And we, of course, also have the wings coming down on each side here, to the left and to the right, in a symmetrical shape here. And the leg will come down something like this. So this is the main composition of the bird. We have the head going down to the neck, and the body continuing into the tail of the bird. We have the hip joint and the wing joint, and the two wings going down on each side. And we have the leg with the foot connecting to the hip joint. Now let's draw in the contour of the main shapes. Let's start at the bottom of the bird here. Just draw it in roughly at first. Creating the contours of the body here. Going up the neck. See if we can get somewhat of an S shape in here. And the wings. And then they fan out a bit. So they are, the width of the wing is thinner at the base and spreading out as we come further down the wing. And the same for the other one. Just trying to get them somewhat symmetrical. And the leg, it takes the curve of the chest and then continues into the leg and downwards into the foot, something like this. And of course the spiral joint we can draw in like this. Taking the outline from the back of the animal, or the rear end, the tail, going into the spiral hip here, and the joint for the wings will mirror that shape. So we just take the outline here and draw it in. Just cleaning it up a bit to make space for the wings connecting to the body here. So you take the lower contour of the wing and curling it inwards and connecting it to the top of the back of the bird. Something like this. And you don't want this piece to be too wide. So that's the overall shapes. Let's go in and add some detail to it. Let's start at the hip joint here. Just tracing the line of the tail. The other side. Drawing it down into the wing. Let's just leave it there and go to the other side and connect the wing to the neck. And the chest. And you want to leave in a little room between the spiral joint and the front side of the leg here. And then just trace it down into the foot. So let's take a look at the head of the bird. We want to give it a nice curvy beak following the this is where the S-curve comes in. You want to have a nice S-curve from the tip of the beak down the neck and down into the chest, making an S-curve here. And also on the other side, like this. So then we have the beak coming round here, up to the top of the head, and the lower jaw going into the mouth of the bird, and then out again to the upper jaw or the beak. And need a little more space inside the head. To fit in the eye. And of course it's an almond-shaped eye. But the lower contour just continues out past the point of the almond shape and then into the edge of the upper side of the head. And the curve of the lower jaw will just continue it a bit back there and add in a palette between the eye and the jaw. The lower jaw here. And then we want to add a neck tendril coming off the head here. Let's just make a gap there and take the back of the neck. Draw it round in a loop and then out here and continue the curve of the top of the head into this leaf shape. Which is, of course, very typical for the style. Like that. And let's continue with the wings. Start with the spiral. And again, you want to leave a little bit of space between the outer edge and the spiral here. And then just going round, following the curve. And a nice S-curve here. And the other side. Again, a nice S-curve. And then the other wing. Nice S-curve. And the other side, again here. So, this is the main outline of the bird. And we can start adding in some detail to the wings and the tail. But first let us add in a few pellets here. So the spiral, this is very typical for the style again, and to the hip spiral as well, like that. And then we'll take a look at the wings. We'll divide it into three main feathers. Also the other wing, same thing here, divided into three main feathers. Like that. And the same with the tail. We'll divide it into three. Each of these feathers will divide into two from around here. I think we'll have a narrow strand at the top and a wider one at the bottom of the feather. And the top one will go like this out into a circular terminal. And we'll do the same with the one below here. We'll divide it up into two strands and add a terminal circle here. And the same with the next one, the third one, like this. Clean it up a bit. And then we can add in the feather, the large feather, to each of the three strands here, like this. So you have three main feathers divided up into two strands each, with a thin one and a thicker one. And we'll just continue with the other wing and the tail in the same manner. And to the tail as well. like that. I'll just clean it up a bit. That's it. There we have the bird. And now, of course, all the lines are in a giant mess, so we just want to clean it up so we can see what goes above and what goes below. I'll just erase this one. Will go, the wing to the left will go above the neck like this, and the wing to the right will go below the tail. Like this. So now we're ready to ink in the animal, the bird. So I'll just go ahead and fill in the black ink.